And on top of that, in the humanities, the opportunities to publish, to get a long argument into print, are declining because there's no profit in it. And I will point to my book as a good example of that. Just for a matter of scale, you read about the latest Stephen King novel hitting the press, and then for me, I think about the risk the University of Pittsburgh took in publishing 1,000 copies of my book, which have not all sold in 2 years. So that's, there's some out front if you'd like to help me along, but you see, even if they'd sold in 3 months, how much profit could that have generated? The next biggest charge against the humanities is the culture wars. I listened to these absolutely wonderful student presentations yesterday. These inspiring, articulate undergraduates discussing the work they're doing. And this phrase stuck in my head. One of the students was working on stereotypes about race. And even though she's interrogating issues of race, she said quite unselfconsciously, in our politically correct times. And that's a concession that the university is a place where there's a battle over values. And the fact that this has attracted so much attention in the press is because people outside the university feel that perhaps it's not a fair battle. The consequences of this for state institutions across the nation have been profound. Not only the culture wars, but since we have moved to a tax system, which is really an a la carte system, that is, the effort is to return more money to the individual, and the individual then makes a choice about what to support. That means there's less money for education, unless when you get your refund, you just sign it over at Clemson. And people don't do that, right? They certainly don't do it in New Jersey. There's declining public support over the amount of time it takes to get through higher education, the cost, the personal debt students assume. And finally, academic freedom is threatened. It's gonna happen in the next 6 months. Some faculty member is gonna be on YouTube. It's inevitable. You just hope it's not somebody at your institution. But the ability to record and immediately distribute perhaps unfortunate exchanges, unfortunate modes of expression, a discussion, a disagreement in class, there's no way it's not going to hit the press. All of this is a way of exposing quickly and thoughtlessly a sense to how teaching takes place is not justified or fair. Now don't worry, I didn't call my talk World's End and just have a big bowl of poison out there for you. Okay. But the argument of my book and my defense of the humanities rests upon an encounter with objective reality. And if we don't confront the reality of our time, then in fact humanities is just a way of entertaining yourself. It's just a fantasy world that you can escape to. And I argue that that's a misuse of the profound power that the humanities have to construct a better world. But that only comes through an encounter with the world we have, the fallen world. Speaking of falling, to move into statistics, we have a tremendous growth in bachelor's degrees over the past 35 years, from 800,000 to 1,400,000 per year. But that growth isn't taking place in my discipline. My discipline's way down here. And it's not taking place in the humanities as a whole. Look at that. We've got 600,000 more BAs every year, and these numbers don't climb at all. And so as a percentage now in the university, you can look for humanities BAs resting at around 15-17% of the total population. So you wonder why the humanities are underfunded in the university. It's a straight game of numbers. You only represent 17% of the student population. You're not going to get a large piece of the pie. BAs majoring in English nationwide, I'm sorry to be preoccupied with my own discipline, but it is where I see this fight being waged most directly. English fell from the 70s, a high of 8% of the degrees, to now settling out at below 4%. I see this on the ground in my university, and the descent is actually greater. Over the period from 1990 to 2002, we've lost 22% of students taking English classes. If you're going to talk about the power of the humanities, but nobody's taking the classes, who's it powerful for? The drop in degrees at my university is even greater. You'll see here graduates majoring in English declined 6.5% of the total and 4.14% of the total in 2002. So at my university, there are fewer students taking English classes and there are fewer students majoring in English. It's not just happening in English. Here I looked at some selected languages. You can see here the decline in German majors, almost a 50% decline over 30 years. French has fallen even more dramatically. And then what's the language that's taken off? Spanish. So here this graph is the same information, but you can see that total, we have fewer students majoring in foreign languages, and we also see what could be called the Spanification of foreign languages as well. Now, if you think about a global culture and globalization, how can we participate in a global culture if we are monolingual? Now, you might say, well, it's a luxury to be able to order French wine in French. And you're right, it is not a luxury to speak Arabic right now. And if we want to think about one of the reasons why we're performing so poorly in the Middle East, it's because we are a nation that is monolingual. So, if I weren't chair of an English department, I might not feel so passionately about these issues. I might not feel them pressing so much, but I have a very keen sense that if the humanities does not move, if it doesn't change, we will go the way of the classics. It's not that there won't be a humanities department anymore, but it'll have five people in it.